Hey guys, today I'm going to go over three offensive zone plays that should generate offense for you and your teammates. So, if the puck is here, getting dropped here on this dot, the first play I want to go over is what I call an over-under play. Okay, it's going to be great to generate offense because it confuses the defenseman. Generally, when you're at a face-off, the defensive team will be lined up in a manner that's going to have to go man on man if they lose the draw. Okay, so this play is like so. Centerman, win the puck back to your defenseman. Okay, the inside forward is going to loop up and around. The outside forward is going to loop down and around, opening up space over here for his teammate. So as the outside forward moves down and around, his defenseman will follow him in that pattern. Now, as a centerman who wins a draw, your job is to fight through and get right to the net and try to create a pick somewhere in here so this defenseman can't get to this outside forward. So, as this guy comes around, defenseman, you have multiple options, okay? First, what I want you to do is get your feet moving to the middle of the ice, okay? Move to the middle of the ice here. Your partner can slide out and is available for an option pass. Next, now that this forward's over here to the outside, you have the ability to pass to him. Okay? Finally, you have the ability to put it on net where you have the centerman and your outside forward going to. Now, when you make this play to this guy right here, let's say you go here with the puck, the forward on the outside, now you have a lot of options, okay? You can go back to that D for a one-timer. You can go right to the net for a shot. You can go down low to the forward that came underneath. But the good news is you have a lot of options. Okay, guys, the first face-off we've talked about is over-under. So as the video plays here, you see the guy from the inside going towards the boards over the top, the guy from the outside going underneath to the front of the net. Rasmus Dahlin does a great job of pulling puck to the middle, giving it to the guy on the boards. The guy on the boards has options now. He goes back to Rasmus Dahlin, who passes to Reinhardt for a 1-T goal. The next face-off play I want to go over is called the shooter back. Okay, you see a lot of times in the NHL, this is a great, great face-off play that's quick and effective. So, if you're lined up, I want one forward offset from the hash marks a little bit. He's offset here. Centerman's obviously in the centerman position taking the draw. The inside forward, you're right on the hash marks. Now, the defenseman, instead of being here and here, you're shifted over slightly, okay, to give the guy on the wall more options. So the centerman, your job is to try to win the puck right back to your teammate here. As you win that puck back, centerman, what you're doing is you are impeding this defenseman's progress here. So the center you took the draw against, you're impeding his progress to try to get to that guy. Now, more often times than not, there's going to be a defenseman here. He has to come all the way to get you. That's why we offset. That's why you line up off the line so he has no chance of getting you. Now, forward, once you get that puck, you have multiple options. First thing I want you to do, though, is take a step to the middle of the ice, okay? When you do that, these defensemen in front of the net are going to be pushing out at you, trying to block that shot. This forward, that's your job to impede their progress by stepping in front of them and don't let them come out to that guy. Now, defenseman, as this forward moves over with the puck, you need to slide down, okay? Now, this forward, you have multiple options from here. You could take a shot yourself, which Ovechkin does a lot, and he scores a lot of goals like that. You could fake a shot and pass to this defenseman, or you can fake a shot and pass to the far defenseman. But there's three options that you have, and all of them can generate a great scoring chance. Guys, in this next clip, you're gonna see the New York Rangers are on offense here and they run a shooter back. So as you can see, the guy on the wall is off the hash mark, allowing him time and space from that defenseman who's gonna try to close on him. As this plays out, the centerman wins the draw, and when it gets to the guy's hands, he passes to the far defenseman for a one-timer goal. Okay guys, the last face-off play I'm gonna go over is called the center walk. So, defensively, teams are generally lined up like this. Forward on the wall, forward in the middle, 2D in front. Now, your team is gonna line up with a forward right behind the centerman, okay? Another forward is gonna be near the hash mark, but kinda lined up towards more middle of the ice. Centerman's obviously taking the draw, D lined up normally. Okay, the objective of this one is to think, make the other team think that you wanna draw the puck back to this guy right here for a shot, okay? As a centerman, there's a couple deceptive things you can do. Going up to the faceoff, you can tell your teammate behind you to be ready. Be ready for the shot. You could also tell this guy in front of the net that it's going back. Just little things like that to mess with the defensive team. Now, center. The ref is going to drop the puck from over here, okay? So, as he drops the puck, your job is to push the puck through this center's legs. And you're taking this route around him, okay? So you act like you're gonna be drawing it back. As soon as the puck drops, you push the puck through the forward's legs, walk around him, gather that puck. Now, while that's going on, this forward, these defensive forwards and defensemen will try to push out at this guy because they think the puck's going to there. That's when you just spin off and aim right for the back post. Weak side D, you come in the soft area right here, okay? Now, if all goes according to plan, right when you walk, this forward, this defenseman might be caught. This defenseman may go with him, may not. So now you have options as a centerman. You could shoot it, take it to the net yourself. You can aim for this guy going to the back door, or if all these guys read the play and collapse on you, who do you have? You have the late weak side D. So in this clip, you're gonna see Rich Peverly walk the centerman and pass back door to set up Pouliot's goal. So as you can see, this is what I was talking about when the center uses a little bit of deception. So Rich Peverly sets up for this draw and his bottom hand is turned over like he's gonna win the puck back to his defenseman. But instead, what does he do? Puck drops, puts right through the back, right through the centerman's legs, passes back door to Pouliot. Now, important thing here is watch how fast Pouliot gets off the line. Gets off the hash marks, drives right to the back post. And for Rich Peverly, all he needs to do, it doesn't need to be a perfect pass, he just needs to put it in an area for Pouliot to set up a goal. That's just a fun way to be creative and maybe get some offense out of it. But nonetheless, here are the three face-off plays that we went over today. We have over-under, shooter back, and center walk. Hope this helps generate some offense.